Hey guys, Generalist Programmer here, and today we're going to be talking about how we can create a drag and drop system in our Unity games. So what I'm going to do is just create a simple example where we've got a square and we're going to have a script which we can then allow our square to be dragged and dropped around our scene. So this is very useful in your inventory systems and maybe hyper-casual games where you need to actually move objects around. So let's just jump into this tutorial. So the first thing I want to do is just create a folder for our scripts and a folder for our objects. Going to be our square. So first of all, in our objects, I just want to go and right-click and create the sprite, the square, and I'm going to drop that into the scene, and I'm going to add a component box collider 2D to it. And then back in our object, well, script, I'm going to create a C# script called drag and drop. Okay, so now I just simply want to attach this to our square, so I'm just going to drop it onto our square like that. So now let's hop into Visual Studio and start writing the code for this drag and drop script. Alright, so here we are in Visual Studio. I'm just going to open this up. And starting from scratch, we're just going to have to create a few variables initially. One of which is we need to create a boolean for can move, boolean for dragging, so that we know we are in a dragging state. And we need a collider D, which is going to hold our collider 2D over here. It's then going to hold our square, its collider. So initially we're going to just set this to get component collider 2D. And we're going to set our can move and dragging to false. So in our update method, what we want to do is we want to get some input from our mouse. So we're going to just do a check of input get mouse button down. So we're going to look at 0, which is the left mouse button. Before we do this, we just want to get a mouse position. So we'll take create a vector 2, which is going to be mouse pulse, and we're going to set this to our camera dot main dot screen to world point. So this is just so that we can get the world point of our actual mouse position. So just have input dot mouse position in here. So when we click the mouse button down, we just want to do some checks. So one of which is we want to make sure that we are actually colliding with our square object using our mouse position. So what we'll do is we'll do an if. We'll check our collider is equal to physics 2D dot overlap point. So we're just going to check that these points overlap so that we know that we're actually clicking on our square object. So we'll add our mouse position here. And when this is true, we'll know that we can now move. So we'll just say that's true. And otherwise, if we're not touching or clicking on our square, then can move will be false. So the next thing we need to do is just make sure that we now set that we are dragging. So in order to do that, we at this point in the code we'll just say if can move, then we are basically dragging at this point, because first of all our mouse button is down and we can move, so therefore we are in a dragging state at this point. Next, we just want to make sure if it's dragging, then we can go and update our position of our square. So set our dis.transform.position equal to our mouse position. And then finally, we're just going to do an if statement to check if our mouse button is up. And that's going to be 0 again for our left click. And we'll then just say can move equal to false. No longer moving, and now released our button, and we're also not dragging anymore because we've released our button. Great, save that, and now we can head back into Unity and test this out. So I'll hit play, And I'll click and I can drag it around. And when I release the button, it doesn't drag anymore. So great, this is useful for your inventory systems, drag and drop type of games where you need to, maybe if you want to do a fashion game where you need to drop clothing or whatever onto your players, or you want to do a hyper casual game where you need to drag things around, then this is a great script to start with. So it's great for PC. You can adapt this to work on mobile by using input.touchpoints. Let me know if you want me to do a tutorial on that, then I can actually do another tutorial where we can look at touch points on a mobile device. Guys, I hope this was useful. I hope you can use it. If you like this video, please like below and subscribe. And great, guys, thanks for watching. See you in the next one. Cheers.